Here's another poem with a long title, and it's a different kind of curse poem. It's the curse poem of satire. So this is a curse poem in a deliberately lighter vein. Here's the background. I don't know if this happens anywhere else, but it certainly happens in New England. And this is the phenomenon of the Mexican restaurant owned by non-Mexicans, right? It's like a chain, with a catchy name. When you go into the restaurant, you notice the hostess is Anglo, the bartender's Anglo, the waitstaff is Anglo, the manager is Anglo. Nobody speaks Spanish. And then you ask yourself, quite reasonably, where are the Mexicans? And then the kitchen door swings open. There are the Mexicans, along with the Salvadorans, the Guatemalans, the Puerto Ricans, anyone else who's actually doing the cooking. It's almost as if a line's been drawn right down the middle of the restaurant, and thus the reference to Jim Crow. It's quite deliberately segregated in this day and age. I guess the idea is to serve non-threatening Mexican food, Spanish not spoken here. We'll take your food, then kick you out of the country. But the result, once again, is, and this is quite serious, to separate the products of a culture from the people who produce them. Right? Remove the objectionable characteristic, which here happens to be human beings. Now, this used to annoy me. A lot of things annoy me. I'm easily irritated. And then it infuriated me. Something happened to my cousin Esteban, who is Puerto Rican and black, who worked in one of these places, and just wanted to come out of the kitchen and be a waiter. And they said, no, you wear dreadlocks. That's unsanitary. And our customers would be uncomfortable in your presence. So he quit. He told me the story. And I said, slow down so I can get it all. And then I wrote this poem with a very long lyrical and symbolic title. For the Jim Crow Mexican restaurant in Cambridge, Massachusetts, where my cousin Esteban is forbidden to wait tables because he wears dreadlocks. I have noticed that the hostess in peasant dress, the waitstaff, and the boss share the complexion of a flour tortilla. I have spooked the servers at my table by trilling the word burrito. I am aware of your t-shirt solidarity with the refugees of the Americas since they steam in your kitchen. I know my cousin Esteban, the sculptor, rolled tortillas in your kitchen with the fingertips of ancestral Puerto Rican cigar makers. I understand he wanted to be a waiter, but you proclaimed his black dreadlocks unclean. So he hissed in Spanish, and his apron collapsed on the floor. May la migra handcuff the waitstaff as suspected illegal aliens from Canada. May 100 mice dive from the oven like diminutive leaping dolphins during your Board of Health inspection. May the kitchen workers strike, sitting with folded hands as enchiladas blacken and twisters of smoke panic the customers. May a Zapatista squadron commandeer the refrigerator liberating a pillar of tortillas at gunpoint. May you hallucinate dreadlocks braided in thick vines around your ankles. And may the Aztec gods, pinned like butterflies to the menu, wait for you in the parking lot at midnight, demanding that you spell their names.